Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Hope you're all doing well. This is obviously a different video, you can tell by the title. I feel like I'm saying this every single time I start a video now. This is a different video, but it actually is. So I haven't done one of these before. Basically, I kind of thought it'd be a cute idea to just let you guys like snoop in my personal belongings. Like, I thought it'd be cute to kind of give you an insight into my closets. I mean, I did give you all an apartment tour a while ago, and I'm not sure. I think I did go into my actual closets then. I think I did, but anyway. I'll give you all a little tour in my closets and in my little shoe closets. My cupboards are packed, packed right now. Obviously not a bad problem to have, but still a bad problem to have. Actually, no, I really cannot claim that as a bad problem. That is like the most first world problem thing I've ever said. Anyway, I'll also give you a little tour of my handbag, or okay, what's in my bag kind of video. I've never done one of those before either, so it's basically just showing you my bag and showing you everything that's in it. I have not touched anything inside it, so it's all like authentic. And I also thought it might be cute and kind of weird. It's maybe a little bit weird, and I'm not sure if I'm kind of crossing the line here, but giving you guys a little sneak peek into my fridge and my cupboard. I don't know. I mean, I thought it would be cute. Like, I would like to see what's in someone else's fridge, and considering I don't really cook, I mean, it won't take really long, so win-win. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoy it. I also got a haircut too, so I hope you also enjoy that. I got a little trim and my roots done. Nothing better than being like freshly blonde. Okay, so I'm gonna start with my handbag because I'm already sitting down, so it just kind of makes more sense. This is the Givenchy Antigona bag in medium. I believe the size is medium. Just comes with that big kind of arm strap, which comes in handy so often you have no idea. And then it looks like that on the back. I should have actually cleaned it before I showed you, but hey, it makes it more genuine, doesn't it? The bottom's like that. I do kind of wish I had little studs on the bottom to protect the bottom of it, but can't always get what you want. And then it's just got a very big chunky zip. All right, the first thing I saw, and I'm not purposely showing you this first, I swear, is this little Tiffany & Co. pen. I received this when I signed a contract. So it was just a little pink pen, very cute. You just wind it up like that, and then you write with it, funnily enough. Next is this little thing here. I will just open it. I received this at New York Fashion Week in a gift bag. It is this little Olio clip thing here. What's it called? Yeah, oh no, Olo clip. Oh, I've been calling it Olio clip, but it's Olio clip. Anyway, you basically stick this onto your phone camera, like on the corner, and it gives you like a fisheye effect. And it actually comes in handy at really random times, so I just kind of keep it in my bag because it's really small anyway. In the other pocket, I've got business cards and I've got another business card. I really need a little file thing for those. In the same pocket, I've got MAC Pure Zen, probably my favorite lipsticks, just a perfect kind of creamy nude. And because I wear it so often, I normally end up just chucking it in my bag before I leave, just so that I know that I've always got it in case I'm eating and it rubs off mid-feast. Next, I've got this Tangley's Lady Jane. It's like one of those Tangle teasers, but it's like the travel version, and it comes with this little clip that you just kind of like clip in there. I don't know. The bristles aren't as nice as my proper Tangle teaser. Like, they're not as soft. They're actually kind of painful, but I mean, just for quickly brushing your hair, it does the job, and it's good that it has the little case. Next, I've got my wallet. This is the YSL. I don't even know what type of wallet it is, but it's just YSL. Regretting buying it in cream because it got dirty, and the only reason I bought it in cream is because black had sold out. So yeah, I've just got stuff in there, but I'm not going to show you because that's private. I've got a packet of Mentos, the spearmint flavor. This is my favorite spearmint flavored gum. Like, I know there's billions of spearmint flavored gums, but this is like a different kind of spearmint, and I really, really like it. So, love it. I've got four chewy wrappers. They're all empty. And then a really torn up other one that has like two left, but I'm still holding on. Next, I've got a packet of Woolworths Select pocket tissues. I've got a little pocket mirror. This thing, oh, the most handiest, convenient thing in the world, even though it's just a mirror. There is something in my eyeball. It is YSL. I didn't buy this. I received it from a girl who was working at a YSL counter back when I worked for Bobby Brown. She just gave it to me, so I snatched that one up, and it is so handy. I have some safety pins. You can never go wrong with safety pins. Then I've got my keys, Bic Market Ultra Fine Point Permanent Marker. Glasses, these are Chanel glasses. I bought these in New York. I mean, they're cute. They're kind of what I wear when I'm like wearing a fancier, more elegant outfit, which I don't do very often. So I never really wear these, and I kind of regret buying them because it's just a waste of money because I don't wear them. Ones that I loved, loved, I left in LA and they were sent back to me, but they got lost in the mail. So I currently do not wear sunglasses. Got a pair of Apple earphones. I barely use those anymore because I drive everywhere. So I just put music on in my car. Another business card. I have my Lanta tablets, and these are great because if you're ever wearing something that's really tight and you have to suck in, because let's be honest, most of us do have to suck in at some point wearing some particular outfit, I always get indigestion and like kind of, yeah, really painful feeling in my stomach from sucking in when I'm wearing a really tight dress. So I don't know, I just find having my Lanta kind of helps me with indigestion. Makeup Forever Duo Matte Powder Foundation. This is not always in here, but it was in here from when I went to Perth and I had it on the plane. I love taking this with me on board flights and traveling because it is quite a good coverage foundation. And so I just use the little sponge. Normally I never use sponges, but for this particular purpose, it kind of just helps and works well. But yeah, I just use this like around my mouth or my forehead, anywhere that I constantly like am touching, because it just adds the coverage back onto my face and keeps my makeup looking fresh. I've got a mascara spoolie and a pen. I am not too sure why I have that. Then I've got a bunch of keys and a garage door thing. This is for my new apartment that I just received today. So I am going to be moving out of this apartment into a 2-bedroom, 2-bathroom in Bondi. Because I live where I work, I do need the space. It's not just me being selfish and being a diva. I actually do need more space. So exciting times ahead. The last thing is this little bag. This is from makeup store. It is very, very handy because it's clear. And this contains all of my beauty things. So this is an EOS lip balm. I actually don't really like these, but I just keep it in there for, you know, extreme situations when I have really dry lips. No, I'm kidding, but oh well, I actually do use it for that purpose. But yeah, just for like planes and things like that, comes in handy. Hand sanitizer, love me some hand sanitizer, and this Radox one smells really, really nice. This is a little Neutrogena hand cream. It's actually really weird, it's like clear, and I don't know, it's weird. I just bought it when I was going to LA, so I don't know, just keep it in there because it comes in handy. Little comb, I've got some Essence Me and My Ice Cream hand wipes. These smell very, very much like sweet dessert, and it kind of gets a little bit too much sometimes, but oh well. Dettol hand sanitizer, it's like a full one. I am anal about, you know, needing to have clean sanitized hands before I eat with my hands. Rimmel Apocalypse lip lacquer, I hate that word, in the shade phenomenon. I'm struggling with my pronunciation today. I swear I do know how to pronounce words. This is the Swispers cucumber 5 facial cleansing wipes. Actually kind of dirty. This was pretty much the same thing for when I fly. I've got some sanitary pads. Just because you can never be too sure. Band-aids, this is like the jumbo one. Also for the same reason, you can never be too sure. I wear a lot of shoes that hurt my feet. And so I kind of just think one step ahead. And I try to kind of bring a little like emergency kit. This is the Bell Diopium, I can't pronounce fancy French words, by YSL. Not a huge fan of the smell, but it comes in handy every now and then. And this is the Lady Gaga Fame thing. I also don't really use this very often, but it comes in handy when I'm desperate to smell good. This is 1000 hour nail file. I hate when you like snag your nails on something and then it's all rough and it's just annoying. another band-aid, just a normal sized one. And then I have three tampons. So yeah, I like to use the applicator ones because I find that they are the most hygienic and you don't have to go too close to your body. Like, not that I'm scared of my own body because that's ridiculous, but I mean, I would rather opt for the more hygienic way of using tampons. Wow, I sound like a really awkward like mum trying to talk to the kids about puberty. Basically, yeah. And there you go. So you've now seen what is inside my bag. There.
So as you can see, this is my little shoe and handbag closet. I'll just give you a quick overview before I show you in depth. So up there, I've just got some of my clutches that aren't expensive ones, just ones that I take out clubbing. In that little Giuseppe Zanotti box, where's my hand? There it is, right there. That is where I keep all of my dust bags for my designer shoes and bags and stuff. I just like to keep them in case I want to go traveling. Then I've got my designer little clutches, such as YSL, Givenchy, and those are just some Kenneth Cole little flats. So these are my designer shoes. Before anyone says anything about having designer shoes, I spend my money responsibly. I save a lot of my money, most of my money, but when I want to spoil myself and reward myself, I will, and I'm allowed to do that, and I tend to do that with shoes. I never buy designer heels, ever, ever, ever. These are my five kind of staple ones. They go with pretty much anything, and that's why I bought them, because they are versatile and I can wear them over and over again. Those ones are YSL, those are Givenchy, those are Valentino, Tom Ford, and these are some new ones from Kenneth Cole. Then I've got my boots. So these ones here are by Senso. These are Giuseppe Zanotti, these are Gucci, those are Witna, yes, and the little flats are by Givenchy as well. Now for my favourite little section, my sneakers. These ones are Marc Jacobs, these ones are Saint Laurent, these ones are Versace, these are Giuseppe Zanotti, and these are Isabel Marant. And then down here, as you can see, it's just an absolute mess of shoes just thrown into this little section. And those are my clubbing shoes. I do not wear my fancy shoes out clubbing because that is very, very silly because they just get destroyed. Okay, so here one of my closets. Something amazing about this apartment is the closet space. It is just incredible, and I'm not sure what I'm going to do in my new apartment because I do have a lot of stuff. Up there is just all the boxes and stuff from the stuff that I've bought, obviously.
So here I have some little midriff kind of tank tops. I don't really wear these very often, but it's good to have them in case I do decide to wear them. Then just some more, and then we reach kind of longer sleeve crop tops. It's all kind of messed up at the moment. I haven't really gone through and cleaned it because I wanted to make this more genuine and like actually how it looks when I'm just living my day-to-day life, not all like perfected. So then I've got some tank tops, small little singlet tank tops, basically just tops that don't have any sleeves. And then following along from that, I've got lots of little crop t-shirts. It's actually quite hard for me to show you these items, but just lots of t-shirts. Mainly black and white because you guys know that I tend to stick with the black and white theme. Just all different kinds of t-shirts. Then I've got some long sleeves here and then some random kind of like lacy or more evening kind of tops, and then all of my blouses because I actually do love to wear like blouses, and then just my longer t-shirts because I also love to wear these. And down here I've just got a robe that my mum bought me, a Peter Alexander robe. Back there is a Victoria's Secret robe, and then another robe that my mum made me, and then I've got lots of hoodies because I'm running out of room for all my hoodies. And then in that top drawer, bras, undies, socks. Don't need to be seen because they're my bras, undies, and socks. So in case you missed my other video on my apartment tour, so this is how my little closet area is set up. And then there I've got my bedroom. These are all of my dresses and my jackets. You can also see the thing that they're all hanging off is bending in the middle because I have that much stuff. And it's just, it's so heavy. Alright, so yeah, I've got some white dresses, some shift dresses. What else do I have? And I've got my red ones. It's so hard to get in here because it's that like tightly packed. Not trying to brag. I should have kind of clarified that before, but I just assumed you guys would know. And then I'm reaching all of my jackets. It's a little fluffy jacket. Yeah, so I'll just briefly go through all of these. Jackets, vest. What is that? Jackets, vest, denim things, top. And then I've got my expensive Isabel Marant things there that I just kind of keep to the side. And then some... Sorry about the sound effects, but then I've got some belts back there and some scarves. And down here, if you can see, that's where I keep all of the boots and sandals that I don't really wear. So here we have all of my shorts and my skirts. I quite like this cupboard because it's just very easy to navigate because it's not jam-packed, but it's just also nice and colour coordinated. Excuse me, hiccups. it's also colour coordinated. So just got like fitted long skirts on the side. Yeah, those are all my longer ones, as you can see by the length of the other skirts. And some skirts and yeah, shorts and stuff. And then just some white ones, then some denim ones. Colourful ones, which I have not worn in forever, and then some little patterned ones. I never wear patterns, so this is a rare sight. And in here I have some shoes. So those ones there are Jeffrey Campbell, those are River Island, those I believe are River Island as well. Those are from Beginning Boutique, those are from ASOS, those are from Zara. And then in here I've got my kind of trainers on my little sneakers that aren't designer. So I've got these Converse little wedge sneakers, and then I've got these new Converse. I literally got these like yesterday. They're like waterproof rubber Converse. Really weird, but cool, I guess. And then these are some black Converse high tops as well. Then some Nikes. Yes, so just the plain black and white ones, and then these ones, which are my new ones, which I'm obsessed with. And then in here, if I pull this out, yeah, all of my jeans. So this thing is like jam-packed, all my jeans and like chinos. Love those. And then I've got all of my like black pants that aren't jeans, basically. And then I'm not even gonna be able to open that. That is where I keep all of my pajamas. Okay, here is my cupboard, and just so you know, I have not touched any of this. As you can see, it's kind of messy. Up there, I've got all of my teas and things like that. As you can see, I'm a big tea gal. There's lots of tea behind there, but you can't really see it. And then just plain flour and shizzle. Then I've got some protein powder just because it tastes really good and it's protein, so it can't go wrong. Then I've got some nuts, some chia seeds, some cinnamon, chewies, Kruskets, a huge heap of serviettes that I bought from IKEA that I'm never gonna use, and some stupid mocha stuff that I thought was gonna be like hazelnut latte, like non-coffee tasting. It makes sense, but it tastes like coffee and I hate coffee, so ew. Some Sanchuros, like drinking chocolate, Vegemite, of course, yay, Australia, Weet-Bix, chocolate, porridge, chia seeds back there, then a can of Beast Milo, and then a can of normal Milo, and then some soy milk. Down here is all of the stuff that I would use if I cooked. That's why this is so like heavily stocked, just because I never go and use any of it. And then my sandwich toaster, some pans and stuff, beaters, blender, toaster. I keep all of that in here just because it's easier. So yeah. So thank you all so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed your little snoop around my apartment and into my life. I would love for you guys to film a similar one if you have a channel or something like that. I find these kind of things really interesting because everyone loves to snoop around in other people's personal lives, let's be honest. Anyway, thank you all so much for watching. Love you all, and I'll see you all very soon. Bye.